Hey guys, it's Dallas with EcoBattery. Today we're going to discuss the battery installation of the Icon EV carts. All EcoBatteries have a robust battery management system, also known as the BMS, with built-in safeguards to monitor the health of the battery during charging, use, and then storage. This proprietary programming can also integrate with your motor controller to help monitor and regulate the functionality as well. This is the reason that EcoBattery uses CAN communication and offers more integration than any other battery on the market. The 2016 to 2021 model carts came with the Toyota Neos controller. The 2021 was a transition year that came with either a Neos controller or the new Icon controller. Because of those differences, we need to determine which controller you have. It's actually fairly difficult to determine which controller you have by looking at the controller itself. They're covered by a whole bunch of plastic underneath the back of the cart here. We found that the easiest way to determine which controller you have is actually right here in the communication port. If you remove this plug from the communication port, you can see inside that there are four spaces for pins. A Toyota Neos controller will have three pins populated in it, and the new Icon controller will have four pins populated in it. You can see it here, or you can also get to the back side of the port here and see how many wires are coming out of it. Again, three wires are for the Toyota Neos controller and four wires are for the Icon controller. This video will cover the installation for vehicles equipped with the Icon controller. If you have a Neos controller, please see the video in the description below. Okay, as you can see, we've already removed the factory batteries out of the battery compartment and cleaned it up a little bit. So the first thing that we want to do after doing that is we need to remove the factory battery charger. To do so, let's get rid of a few zip ties first. We're going to cut a couple of these. There's a few cable ties across the top here that we want to get loose. Okay, now we need to disconnect the remaining connections from the charger. Let's do the charge port first. And then we're going to do the charger interlock connector. And last, let's do the charger LED status indicator. Now we need to remove the hardware from the charger. There's one bolt on this side and two bolts on this side. If you're installing our 70 volt eco battery, we need to replace the factory reducer with our provided 12 volt reducer. If you are using a 51 volt battery, you can leave the factory 12 volt reducer in place. So to replace the factory 12 volt reducer, we need to disconnect these connections here, two connections. Like so. Next, we need to remove the hardware holding the reducer on. Now we need to route these cables just a little bit differently. This negative cable, I want to pull back through here and bring it out this little hole. Like so. And then this positive cable, I'm going to cut this zip tie here. Pull the positive cable around this side of the post, like so. Now for the carts we're installing the 70 volt eco battery in, let's install the reducer. And reconnect the corresponding plugs. There are three battery hold down bosses in the battery tray. In order to install our batteries, we need to remove the corresponding bosses. If you are doing a 51 volt, 105 amp hour through hole, we are going to remove just this center one. If you are going to install our 51 volt 160 amp hour or our 70 volt battery, we need to remove all three of them. And I'll show you the easiest way that we remove those. We use an oscillating tool for the removal of these. It's very simple. You may need to notch a small amount from these supports as well. Next, let's install our icon-specific eco battery charger. Next, let's connect some of our cables. First, we will connect our LED indicator, then our charger interlock. And finally, our charge port. We're going to cover this charge port connection back up and zip tie it in place. We need to connect our MCU connection from the battery to the MCU. We're going to show the connection going to the MCU and later the battery connection. This small cable connects to a cable that is right back behind the tow run switch. Let's see if I can get it right here for you. It's a little two-pin connection with a black connector on it. Generally, the wire is going to be red and then a black with gray stripe on it. We just need to connect those up. Now we are going to show the installation of the 51 volt through-hole, 51 volt 160 amp hour, and 70 volt batteries. Locate one of the battery hold-down rods, flat washers, and nuts that we removed from the factory batteries. We're going to use it for our 51105 through-hole battery installation. Locate the center of the battery over the threaded hole under the boss that we removed earlier. And then we are going to insert the threaded rod down into the threaded hole. Thread the rod in about half an inch to start. Screw it in. Next, locate the battery top plate. We're going to install it here. The flat washer and the nut. Now you'll notice that we have the seat base here. We want to make sure that the center rod is below that surface so we can adjust it accordingly. We really only need enough sticking out of the top of the top plate here for the nut. Screw it down a little bit further if we need to. Torque the top nut to 10 foot-pounds or 120 inch-pounds. For the 51 volt 160 amp hour battery, align the center mounting holes with the two outer threaded nuts. Now we are going to install our battery hold downs, one on each side, and our M6 bolts. Our next step, we're going to install our charging cables and our battery cables. The cable installation will be the same for all batteries. Always stack the cables in order from the highest load to the lowest load, with the charger on top and the battery cable on the bottom, closest to the terminal. Torque the terminal bolts to 6 foot-pounds or 72 inch-pounds. This is our CAN harness. We need to install that on the battery. That will be our communication network cable that goes between all of our components. On this cable, there are two CAN connections. We want to plug our connection coming from the charger into one of these two ports. It does not matter which one we plug into. And then we are going to plug in our MCU cable into the other one. In our next step, we are going to be replacing the factory cluster with one of our eco battery clusters. We have two different versions of these. We have our standard cluster and our backup camera version. The standard cluster comes in your typical bundle. If you would prefer to have a backup camera version, you can get with your dealer and get one of those ordered. First, let's remove the factory cluster. In our next step, we need to verify that we have CAN populated in our harness. Some carts are populated already and some carts do not have it. What we're looking for is to see if we have any wires in this location and this location, which would be top row, second from the right, and third from the right. If you are already populated here with wires, and we do not need to do anything additional on this step, if it is not populated as shown in this instance, we will be populating those two terminals with our adapter harness shown here. So first we need to disconnect these two connectors here. I find it a little bit difficult sometimes to get these to pop off. The little clip here is difficult to release, so I take a little small screwdriver and insert it right below this clip and just lightly push out. And I will do the same thing here. In this next step, we need to make sure that this connector is unplugged from our cluster. We do not want it plugged in during this step. So we are going to populate, again, the second from the right and third from the right terminals. Our terminal connector here is going to have a blue wire and a brown wire. We want to ensure that we plug the brown wire in the second location from the right, next to the yellow wire shown. Insert that in there. And then the blue wire is going to get inserted next to that in the third location from the right on the top row, as shown here. Next, if our cluster harness wasn't already pre-populated with the CAN pins, we need to run this harness coming from our meter cable off the battery up to the front. We'll run the cluster cable down through the cart here and run it along the frame rail. We're going to run the cable down the frame rail and towards the front of the cart. Once we've routed our cable up to the front, we need to connect these two small connectors. This larger connector does not connect to anything at all. Now we will install the standard eco battery cluster. Connect the two connectors. And install in the dash. To complete the installation on your Icon golf cart, we now need to program the MCU with the Eco Battery Tech Tool. If you do not have an Eco Battery Tech Tool, you can visit your dealer or purchase one for yourself.